How's everybody doing today? This is Antonio Moore coming to you from Tone Talks and theGrio. I want to briefly discuss the Harriet Tubman biopic. The movie Harriet came out this weekend, and its disrespect of black men in the way that it portrayed them in its plot. So when we look at this film, it's supposed to be the story of Harriet Tubman. Harriet Tubman being the black woman who essentially led so many slaves through the Underground Railroad into freedom. It's her narrative and biopic, supposedly, but when we start breaking down the plot, they took so many liberties that they recreated her story to have characters not only that didn't exist, but possibly have no historical anchoring. The first thing that we see is a black male slave catcher named Bigger Long. This Bigger Long is played by Omar Dorsey from Decatur, Georgia, and essentially the character comes out of a creation of a black male slave catcher that never chased Harriet Tubman in any historical records. In fact, going even further, according to books that have been put out by everyone from the Harvard Press and beyond, there might not have been many, if any at all, black slave male slave catchers in the historical archives. Fundamentally, there was so much fear amongst whites of black uprising, the likelihood that they would give a black male a gun to go out and actually catch other black men without the fear that they would then turn on them is very, very, very low. And I don't understand how we got here where we don't understand when you make a biopic, it has to have anchoring. So we started looking at the portrayal of Bigger Long inside of the greater narrative of everyone from Eric Garner to Alton Sterling. The portrayal of black males as violent, leading to their deaths at the hands of police, and we start seeing the danger of it all. Bigger Long is portrayed as just this obtuse figure that never existed. From what I've heard about the plot, essentially he says the reasoning to do this is to catch white whores or something of the sort is the reason he's using this money. None of it is respectful to Harriet's legacy, and it's definitely not respectful to black men. I think this movie is very dangerous in how it mischaracterized the narrative of slavery and the role of black men, let alone also white men and white women in context of this. By many accounts, there were far more white women that were slave catchers than ever existed with black men. Now, white males were the primary slave catchers, but here you have him portrayed not only as a slave catcher, but possibly the biggest and best slave catcher in the South by some people's recollection of the movie. Now, I myself am boycotting the Harriet film for a number of reasons, primarily because the Civil Rights Act of 1866 will be heard in the Supreme Court in less than 2 weeks, November 13th, and essentially Comcast owns NBC Universal, and Focus Features is then owned by NBC Universal. So in effect, Comcast owns the company that put this movie out. So while in 2 weeks they attacked the civil rights that Harriet Tubman, along with Frederick Douglass and so many others, pushed for with the Civil Rights Act of 1866, they put out Harriet's biopic, and then in addition, they interject it with so much that is not written into any of the history books that it isn't Harriet Tubman's biopic at all. Now, we have a long history of black men being demonized and being made into brutes in film. We go back to Birth of the Nation that led to the rise of the Ku Klux Klan that was anchored in a false narrative of white men playing black-faced black men that were savages and running wild and raping white women. How far off is Bigger Long from that portrayal of black men? Not far at all to me. At one point, as I understand it, Bigger Long actually steps on and kills Janelle Monáe's character, a black woman. He basically is running around chasing black women as a brute and a savage, and he never existed. Not just he never existed, there was no black male that ever chased Harriet Tubman by any record. Not just no black male ever chased Harriet Tubman by any record, there's hardly any record of black men chasing anyone as a slave catcher in the South during the antebellum slavery period. I feel like what we start to see is that everybody's trying to make slavery a diverse kind of experience. Cassie Lemons, director of the film, went as far as to say that she wanted to portray that there were that everyone had a role or a part, and in this institution had an effect on it. None of that allows you to recreate history or slavery. I feel in so many ways disrespected as a black man by this movie. I feel that this movie should have been boycotted by NAACP, Urban League, and the like. But now we stand at a different point where this is a disrespectful film to Harriet's legacy, to black men at large, and a dangerous film in the sense that as it's told, it undermines the very narrative and story of how black men actually were victims during the slavery period, not perpetrators of its violence. I continue on by looking at a history that we can go from Birth of a Nation and all the way into King Kong. King Kong's imagery comes out of the brutish idea, and people say, well, that's a big ape. No, it was actually projections of the idea of a brutish black man that was actually chasing after white women, and this white male comes in and saves the day. And we see that in the Harriet film. In the Harriet film, spoiler alert, essentially the white male that is the slave owner that chases, that hires Bigger Long, ends up killing Bigger Long to protect Harriet in some form of love or fashion of the other. And I think that what we overall have to understand is that this is a very big problem when you're trying to make a larger discussion of a black agenda and reparations that are owed to black folks because of mistreatment by the government and white America, because it creates an ahistorical idea that black men, that black people, that black families were enforcers of a white oppression when they weren't part of that institution in that way. This film sits in a problematic position while we're in the middle of demanding a reparations claim from the U.S. government, while we're in the middle of demanding that the U.S. government and Comcast stand down against our Civil Rights Act. I, in addition, start to look at some of the tweets that came out of this thing, and I see so many problems. I want to start off with a tweet that I see that came from a young woman named Tay. She said, I love the Harriet Tubman movie. It opened my eyes so much. For instance, not all Caucasians were ruthless. Some helped free slaves. Some blacks that had freedom was just as bad as the Caucasians. Harriet had so much belief and faith in God. They were one Lord. I pray for that. This young woman had little framing of slavery and walked out with even worse framing. And I feel like that's the danger. Bigger Long to her is a real portrayal of black men. And I think that that's not just her. You had Cynthia Erivo, who played Harriet Tubman, go on the Hot 97 show with Ebro and essentially say that she wanted 12-year-olds to see this film. Well, the problem is that you didn't make a film that was historically accurate. So a 12-year-old walks into this film and walks out with a worse understanding of slavery than they ever had walking in. You had a white woman named Zoe Chance talk about taking her 11-year-old daughter. She says, this is a tweet, took my 11-year-old daughter to Harriet movie last night and I'm still disturbed. She left the theater scared of Bigger Long, the worst bad guy. The only sadistic character in the movie was black and did not exist. WTF Hollywood. I think we don't really see that you can't recreate history and call it a biopic. This movie was disrespectful, demeaning, and dangerous. And I think we gotta start breaking this down and having a discussion that hasn't been had in far too long about those people that have supported this thing walking out and said that it was powerful or enlightening or educational. I mean, I heard Ebro, I heard Michael Dyson, I heard several people actually talk about it in terms of educating America. In what world can a film educate black America or America at large about slavery when it makes up black male slave catchers that never existed? Let's continue on. Professor Sandy Darity out of Duke University, who I did a report with on economics, is one of the leading professors in sense of reparations claims and economics intergenerationally between generations. He had a tweet on this that responded to a Dr. Keisha N. Blaine. Dr. Keisha N. Blaine said, for my fellow historians, movies are not documentaries and documentaries are not movies. Please keep this in mind when critiquing movies on historical figures. I guess this was in response to everybody's basic level critique about this is almost like adding black slave owners that had large plantations. Is that bad? I have no idea what this woman is saying. And in context of us knowing that there has been an idea that this should somehow be shown to 12-year-olds as educational material, not only by people watching it outside, but the actor that played Tubman herself, they've made this movie into a sort of documentary, and that's how they're trying to sell it. So you got to understand, when you don't know what you're talking about as far as the goals of the actual product creators. But in addition, you can't make a biopic and then remake the person's life. This is a recreation of their life. There is no bigger part of Harriet Tubman's story than the fact she had to escape from slavery and then be chased. You just made the person chasing her a black male brute. Now, I don't think you understand the impact of that, but Sandy Darity responded to her and he said, then they should not have named the lead character Harriet Tubman. Now we have a ton of fresh, inaccurate debris to clean up. Biopics should be reasonably consistent with what is known. He compared this to Styrone, and he said, originally published in 1967, Styrone's afterword to the 1992 edition is a stunning confession of his own about his motives and the limited information he used to craft his novel. Having written a work in historical fiction, Styrone said he was filling in blanks left in Thomas Gray's confession of Nat Turner, a professed transcript of Gray's conversations with an imprisoned Turner. So there was this we've seen this before, where Styrone, in context of Turner, tried to recreate things and actually just made things up. And I think that what we start to see is this is what happened here. Harriet, the film, doesn't deserve our support, not only because of the questions around Cynthia Erivo and her disrespect of African Americans, not only because of the fact that Comcast owns the company that created this film, while they're going to go in 2 weeks on November 13th into the Supreme Court and argue against the Civil Rights Act of 1866, but also because the film itself is not only ahistorical, but it also recreates slavery in the image of black men being the perpetrators of the slave violence. None of it is true. I wanted to come to you and have this discussion so that we can get it out into the public and make sure that everybody knows. This is the Grio with Tone Talks. Please share this. Thank you.